Well, a very good crowd enjoying splendid sunshine and the warm temperatures for day two of the 2009 ESB Kate Russell Cup. Coming up right now, it's the battle for first and second place between Colas Dhignáis, the Connacht champions, and Foyle and Londonderry, the Ulster champions. Hello and you're very welcome once again to Three Rock Rovers Hockey Club in Rathfarnham in Dublin. The Kate Russell Cup features six teams from around the country. They're split into two pools of three, and following those pool matches, very evenly contested, it's Foyle and Colas Dhignáis through to the final. Once again, I'm joined pitchside by the Ireland coach, Gene Muller. It really was so tight in those pool matches. It's going to be difficult to separate these teams, you would think.
Yeah, this whole tournament has proven to be really close results, so I expect this to be no different. I think it's going to be an interesting matchup because I think at Colchester have probably a more balanced team, but Foyle have got Megan Fraser, who's a senior international. So I think it'll depend on how well are your good players playing, and that'll determine the outcome of this match.
Colas Dhignáis now, for example, got through to the final after two draws and then penalty flicks. So sometimes that just gives you that little bit of extra incentive, having come through perhaps a little bit fortuitously.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, if you make it through two ties and then you have to go into an overtime situation, it shows that your team is mentally strong, and also it means that maybe they've got something in reserve if they haven't played that well yet. They're hoping to do it in the final.
We'll see. Okay, Gene, take your place up in the commentary box then as we hand you over for team news and all the action in the company of your match commentator, Will Downing.
Colas Dhignáis, better known as the Jez, have Lindsay Traynor to thank for their spot in this Kate Russell Cup final. It was her decisive penalty in the shootout that saw them into this decider. Brenda Flannery and Katie Goddard have plenty of goals in them, but will they today? Foyle and Londonderry have number 9 Megan Fraser as a full Ireland international. Their other goal of the campaign that wasn't a Fraser strike coming from number 14 Leanne Orr, but a strong bench as well. Our umpires for this final, the Olympic official Carol Mechet and John Keogh. We haven't had a Connacht winner in 21 years, so it's a big final for the Jez on this occasion. But Megan Fraser is a lady for Foyle and Londonderry, I'm sure, Gene Muller, that many eyes are going to be on today.
Yeah, hopefully it'll be the Jez's eyes, because she poses a huge threat for them.
We will have a 23rd and new name on this Kate Russell Cup. Neither of these schools have won it before. Much to phone home about today, perhaps. This could be quite a final. No inhibitions. It's all about winning now. It's been Ulster domination of the Kate Russell Cup this decade. Only twice in this millennium has there not been a Northern champion. Well, Taylor's Hill, 1988, remain heading into this final, the last ever Connacht champions at All-Ireland level. Much at stake. The Jez from Galway, Colas Dhignáis, are in, as you might expect, white and maroon. Foyle and Londonderry are in the red, and that's hit just beyond Brian McKinley, who has quite a lot of experience of wearing red. She also plays for Derry City Ladies FC and was the under 14 captain last year, a young midfielder, but lots of potential there. Two captains are Megan Fraser and Orlick Calnan, looking to get their hands on the greatest trophy of schoolgirls hockey. And I know you always look forward to this, Gene. The future's out there.
Yeah, it's a wonderful occasion, and I think we're very lucky to have an event like this. It's what a showpiece for Irish hockey. The players love it. The fans love it. It's always a fantastic event.
Free hit for the Jez, which Brenda Flannery, the vice-captain, has drilled in with some danger towards Holly Lynch, the Foyle goalkeeper. A great Christian name for a keeper, because we had Holly Moore in goal for Bandon Grammar in the 5th-6 playoff, which they came through. St Andrews beat Loretta Wexford in the 3rd-4th, but this is it, the finale. End of a long campaign. Foyle winning Ulster for only the second time and the first time since 1982 against the school with rare provincial glory in the West. It's whipped just beyond Brona McKinley. Support for Brenda Flannery in the middle, and a shooting chance, and it was well blocked down by Victoria McAllister, the vice captain and sweeper for Foyle. Back for Lindsay Traynor, winning penalty yesterday in a table which finished with all three teams in the pool level on points and goal difference, but happily for Cloche d'Ignaud and St Andrews, and more particularly the organisers, they did end up scoring more goals than Ballymena. So it was a two-way shootout instead of a three-way shootout, and a bit of bother for the Jez goalkeeper, Emily Malloy. This is her last match at this level. She's a sixth year, heading on to third level next campaign. Former senior Galway ladies footballer, but now concentrating firmly with a hockey stick in her hand. This is Jane Manning. The free hit is theirs, and well engineered by the head girl of the Foyle and Londonderry school, Jane Manning. But will she be ahead of affairs today? Good ball in towards Megan Fraser. You'll see a lot of her today. But she will hope not like that. She is some talent.
Yeah, she's come through in the last year. She got capped last year at the Celtic Cup and has picked up a few more caps. So she really is a very good prospect for Ireland in the future.
She's only 17. We will see if her potential is realised this afternoon. It will be quite a way to bow out of the school's gate. Hit across well by Michelle Carey, the Connacht under 16, across to Alison Ryan. It's been a big year for Connacht at that level by winning the Interpros for the very first time. And this would round off the Western season quite well.
Yeah, there's good things happening in Connacht at the moment. At junior level, they've produced some good players, some very good teams.
Brenda Flannery, the opening's been engineered. Alison Ryan is there, and they have the penalty corner, but very, very well done.
Yeah, Kadire and Flannery, and they've been two of the stars for the Jazz, them combining. So you can expect to see much more of that this afternoon.
So the first set piece of the day set up for Tara Melvin to strike, but will it be she or will they vary it? Van Murphy is forward as well. They've gone for the former option. Wide it is from Tara Melvin. As they try and engineer the opening goal, 5 minutes in. But just couldn't keep it on target. Megan Fraser, well, there is success in the blood. She's a first cousin of Darren Gibson. What a Carling Cup final he had. Can it run in the family? It might just do. Great ball through, and the touch came from Abby Parkhill, but couldn't keep it on target. Drew keeper Emily Malloy, but couldn't find a way past.
Superb through pass. Weighted, splits the defense.
There will be history in 50 minutes time in this tie, because we'll have a new champion. And as of yet, no one is the closer. Cracked in hard by Michelle Carey, the Connacht under 16, held up by Isabel Mortimer. She knows what it's like to be an All-Ireland champion. In the dim and distant past, she was an All-Ireland squash champion 3 years ago. She's a sixth year now, so this is her last school's hockey game at this level. And Michelle Carey is trying to help her on the way to glory. Brenda Flannery, held up by that girl, Megan Fraser, again. First cousin last month, a winner at Wembley. In a different final in a different sport. Can she emulate the feats of Darren Gibson? It's rolling back to goalkeeper Emily Malloy, the Ireland under 18 for Tara Melvin, her international colleague. Also played in that Connacht under 16 interprovincial success. looking for Isabel Mortimer but couldn't find. Support also from Katie Kadar.
Yeah, Kadar is also a bright prospect for Irish hockey. She is a member of the under 16 international team with designs playing for the under 18s, I'm sure, at the Europeans this year.
Her sister is Niamh Kadar, who's on the bench. Katie starting this tie. Held up by Evan Murphy. Oh, this great Connacht under 16 side, as so many of this panel have enjoyed that start this year. Abby Parkhill has been doing it for Ulster, as has Megan Fraser. Free hit for Tara Melvin. Megan Fraser loves getting in the way. Some good creativity and running, and was balked by Michelle Carey. And Foyle have the penalty corner and potential. There's been a major conflab at the edge of the area. They may just try and vary this. It'll be stopped by Megan Fraser, but you wouldn't put it past her to have a try. Varied it heavily, maybe not the way they wanted to, but here goes Camilla Little. And it's another one. Niece of the Irish rugby legend Ken Goodall. What is it about success that seems to run through sporting families? I wonder if they'll do it differently this time. Fraser had a think. Little. Not sure those penalty corners have come off for them yet, Gene.
No, I think guilty of a bit of over-elaboration. I think still most of the research will show that the simpler the better on penalty corners. See if you can do it in less actions, less chance of something going wrong.
Foyle 2-1 winners over Loretto in their opening group game. Goals from Leanne Orr and Megan Fraser. One all draw against Bandon Grammar, with Fraser scoring again. Closhed ignored. A lot more interesting. One all draw against Ballymena in an Ulster derby. Katie Kadar scored in that. And in the 2-2 draw against St Andrews, Brenda Flannery got the other. But because they were level on points, goals scored and goal difference, it went to a direct penalty competition between the two. Had it finished 1-1. The penalty competition also would have included Ballymena, because all the other games in the group finished 1-1. Now that would have been interesting to organise. Fraser, dangerous, and almost in by Manning.
Yeah, it's a fantastic pass in from the side, also aimed at the far post. It's just perfectly played by Megan. Also, she created it. There should have been someone over there. Simple as that.
Held up by Leanor. Brona McKinley will have chances to build from the sideline, and Fraser to touch on, and has drawn the foul and the free hit in a tasty area. Forward for Fraser, and another chance to show what they can do, but this time will it be simpler?
Yeah, the Jazz will be they'll be disappointed in that. They've given away three fairly simple penalty corners, and they always will be goal-scoring opportunities.
Fraser to stop, but Little won't hit. It's Fraser's shot. Came to the back post and almost struck home. They varied it again, but it didn't pay off, and in painful circumstances too. This is what they went for this time. Just hit with a bit too much venom. Brenda Flannery sent flying. Megan Fraser, the offender, who actually lost her foot in the challenge, you'll see. Free hit out, came off the foot. Chance for Camilla Little to ease the pressure. Lindsay Traynor was pushing forward. Came off the stick of Orla Calden and out. Here goes Camilla Little trying to send the ball through again, and more foil danger. It's Abby Parkhill taking on Sophie McLaughlin, and did well, but it will roll through. And the entrance of Elaine Carey. She's only 13 years old, youngest player on the pitch. Camilla Little striking in, high and a little dangerously, and there will be a free out for the Jez. Quickly taken by Tara Melvin. On by Brenda Flannery. Now there's potential here for the Jez. And Carey, who has pace at the age of 13, plays under 14 ladies football for her county and has quite a bit of speed and is nippy too. Hit in by Tara Melvin and a flick, but it won't count. Not a solid touch.
Coming off the defender's stick in that situation, a long corner.
And members there, some anyway, of the 1982 Cup winning team. Susan McCall is here, plus the winning coach, Hilary McCoy, who I think has just left of shots of that particular group. And all enjoying what the class of 2009 have to offer. Enjoying it from the balcony. Free hit for Brenda Flannery for the Jez. 5 minutes left of a goalless first half. Melvin, good ball in, tried to link up again with Lindsay Traynor. Touched on by Van Murphy. Trying to evade Jane Manning and has done a brilliant job of doing so. Michelle Carey in the middle. Can she finish? Need support in a ride from Katie Kadar, but illegally so. Came in with the foot and Foyle can clear. Kadar pushing forward again and has done well to win the free hit. Short for Brenda Flannery.
I think that's the area of the field that the Jez got to keep on playing, because all the times they've looked dangerous has been in that channel, where a combination of Flannery and Traynor and Kadar will get the advantage in that area.
Traynor has got an advantage now, and so do the Jez. A great opportunity to break the deadlock from a penalty corner. They're first in quite a while. In search of Michelle Carey, Camilla Little balked her. This is set up for a strike from Tara Melvin, but will it arrive or will they vary it? Melvin! Oh, that's brilliantly ghosted. Traynor, she's gone wide. Goalkeeper in a bit of bother. Whistle goes. Melvin ready to dive in. Holly Lynch got the decision her way in her first season as a goalkeeper. Clean sheet for her so far, and that will be maintained for the time being. What a ball, releasing Leanne Orr. Needs support, Parkill in the middle. Orr may go her own way. Penalty corner foils way now. So what plan this time, Gene?
My recommendation, straight stop and straight shot on goal.
We'll see if simplicity is a virtue for them this time. Jones and Fraser, the two there. It's Fraser, it's Jones, it's Fraser. It's in! Megan Fraser breaks the deadlock. It's a foil side lead with 2 minutes left in the first half.
Yeah, really well executed. Megan, although she's playing as a midfielder in this team, Megan would be a striker for the national team. So no surprise that in those situations, she's clinical.
It's their favourite scoreline. 1-0 against Royal Armagh, 1-0 against Ballymena, 1-0 against the Jez. But still a full half of hockey to come. Scored in the two group games. Ever dangerous, ever scoring, Megan Fraser. Her third goal of the campaign. I'm not sure if you'd call this keeping it simple, Gene.
Yeah, maybe if the plan is get it to Megan, it's not so difficult.
One nil it is. And we have 80 seconds left of this first half. By Amanda Brady, a relatively recent recruit. It's her second season in the squad. Most of this foil side play for Priorians in the Ulster Senior League, with the Megan Fraser concentrating on Ballymoney. Trainer aiming for a Van Murphy and did find her. Found her foot though. Little hop and a skip and Brady dispossessed. Support from Yvonne Murphy, but wasn't found, and Katie Goddard dived in with a stick and a bit of trip work. Brona McKinley sent flying. Nicely done, and perfect for Leanne Orr. Their chances here, two in support. But they'll be stopped by the Hooter. It is the end of the first half. And a goal 2 minutes from half-time for Megan Fraser is what divides them in this Kate Russell Cup final. It was a well-worked penalty corner. And Fraser's goal means at half-time, the Jez, Cloisht ignored nil. Foyle and that Londonderry won. We'll be back. Megan Fraser's goal divided them in the Ulster decider, and it is the case again in this Kate Russell Cup final. Foyle a goal to the good. The Jez have half an hour to save themselves. The Galwegians not wanting to be marooned in this final. Early progress down this right flank. It just went beyond Alison Ryan. Held up by Amanda Brady for Foyle. That one previous Ulster Cup win coming in 1982, a 2-0 win over St Dominic's. They've lost a couple of finals since then, painfully, 96 and 97. And in 96, their captain was Catherine Ruff, who's the assistant coach today for Foyle. Hit across the bows, Michelle Carey, and out. That's the Foyle side bench. Manager's Valerie Little, who's... daughter Camilla wears six. Kerry Eakin is the coach. Catherine Ruff, the assistant coach. Kerry Eakin celebrated her nuptials recently in December, having played quite a long time for Priorians in the Ulster Senior League. Lindsay Traynor is making a break forward, but is well stopped. I am informed there are some bells ringing elsewhere in Irish hockey at the moment, but that's a different story. Melvin with a chance to strike and cause some damage. It almost happened too. They have the penalty corner and potential. Brenda Flannery going over to strike. Big discussion between Tara Melvin and Evan Murphy as to what will happen. Flannery to take, Murphy to stop. But will it be Melvin to strike? We won't know for a few more seconds. John Keir wasn't happy with the early breakout from the Foyle defence, so chance for a re-rack. Lots of bodies lurking with intent. It's Flannery to swing it through. Murphy stops it. It is Melvin's shot. Couldn't keep it on target, but they played it simple. Didn't pay off. Tara Melvin of the Interprovincial Under-16s just couldn't quite keep it on target.
Yeah, it's I think the strategy's right, and I think they played the first few minutes of this game in the right way, just keeping in that area, win the freeze, win the corners.
Quick free hit from Lindsay Traynor was crying out for someone to connect, and no one could. School has really had the chance to dominate it yet, and there will be a new name on the famous trophy in 20 minutes time. At the moment, the indications are steering towards Foyle, who are on the attack with Camilla Little. Good ball pushed through, but wide. A big week here in schools hockey. It's been a big week for you as well, Gene, and watching various matches, hasn't it?
Yeah, I'm Ireland, the pools for the Irish national team, the Europeans, have been announced. We're pitted against Germany and Spain, so I managed to watch those two teams play. As a bit of scouting work this week, so both of them are in the top six in the world, so we've got to work cut out, but I don't think unattainable for the Irish team.
Held up by Brenda Flannery. There is support in the overlap from Tara Melvin. Was a good looking move, and it continues that way. Held up in the end by Cora Lapsley, and Camilla Little won't get a chance to squeeze it away. Hit with a bit too much venom. Free hit for Foyle and Londonderry. The group stages of those Europeans are in Amsterdam. It's been a big Dutch trip for Foyle since they won the Ulster title. They drew with Klein Switzerland in Den Haag, in The Hague. Lost to Hockey Club Rotterdam in their impressive stadium. It is pretty much the capital of European hockey, or at least where the money is in European hockey. Leanor forward. It's Holly Rankin. Held up by Brenda Flannery. Chance for the Jets to push forward again with Lindsay Traynor. Stopped by the goalkeeper, but it was hit from outside the scoring zone. This one was hit firmly inside by Katie Kadar. No joy again for the Jez. But there may be a potential Foyle break. Here goes Leanor, and she has pace. She has the touch. The only thing she doesn't have at the moment is support. That and the ball. Way by Melvin. Traynor. Short for Michelle Carey. Support arriving in the middle again, dangerously so. In was diving Elaine Carey, just couldn't get the final connect. Carey, the much younger sister of Michelle, but for a 13-year-old, hasn't been bad. Neither has been this girl, trainer.
Yeah, a really good chance to Kadir.
And it's it! And it's 1-1! Finally it arrives! And who else?
Yeah, that was really going to be the script all along, trainer to Kadir. They've had a few of those chances all game, and this one pays off.
She can't stop scoring. Her fifth goal in four games at this level. Megan Fraser for Foyle, Katie Kadir for the Jays. It's turning out as you might have expected. The two arguably most impressive names on either side have both got on the score sheet. Katie Kadir has cancelled out Megan Fraser's goal. Now we've got a final. Van Murphy held up by Amanda Brady. McKinley held up by Tara Melvin. Camilla Little now found a way past Michelle Carey. Good ball inside. Support from Leanne Orr. A couple of marginal opportunities for her recently haven't gone away, and there will be some action taken here. There was a strike, it's a green card given against Abby Parkhill, who's just come on. First card of this final. Green is the colour. Short by Alison Ryan for Lindsay Traynor. Just went below the stick of Brenda Flannery, the under 17 Ireland soccer international, away games at Poland and Russia. Closer climbs here, and pressure from Leanne Orr, and wonderfully done by Orla Callanan, the captain, doing the skipper's role, got in the way marvellously in her last match at this level before she moves on from sixth year. Corner it is for Foyle. But how well she did.
Yeah, that was, I mean, if she didn't make that tackle, it's a one-on-one against the goalkeeper. So, yeah, it was fantastic bit of cover defending. It was a three-on-one situation, so it needed to be that good.
And the one did well. Stop for Jones, back for Fraser, another stunning block. And a Jez break on the way. Here goes Alison Ryan after the wonderful work originally by Brenda Flannery. Alison Ryan being watched on from the touchline by manager Rita Ryan. It didn't pay off. It's long by Leanne Orr. It's a good one, but it fell under the feet of Abby Parkhill. And with umpire Carol Metchett so close. Stopped by Brona McKinley, and there are options for Fraser to spread forward. And one of those is Camilla Little. A stream of red shirts going forward. Found a way past Tara Melvin. Movement in the middle. Four inside the scoring zone. Fraser is closest to it and will probably receive her chance to do damage now. Great ball in towards the middle and well dealt with by Emily Malloy, the goalkeeper, to flick it away. She may have more work to do though. It stops once more by Orla Callanan, who's done a super job in defence. But her work with 9 minutes to go is surely not yet done. Aim for Elaine Carey. Megan Fraser. Another chance to create something. Camilla Little by her side, Little for Fraser. Brona McKinley's on the overlap. Fraser. Little. Four to aim for in the middle. And those four will stay there. Engrossing stuff, Gene.
Yeah, it's been fascinating watching. There have been a lot of chances in the second half, and it's much more of an open game. It's quite an entertaining game. So, see, this is the only fear that, or the greatest fear for the Jets, is the turnover in the midfield.
McCandless has done so well. It is sweeping effort by Orr, and Malloy stopped it. It was heading in. McCandless, that came out of absolutely nothing. Just a slight defensive lapse. Malloy has kept them in it.
Yeah, that's been the pattern of the chances. The pattern has been foiled with a counter attacks. And the Jets with a build up type of play.
Last touch was Katie Kadire's. Movement in the middle for Foyle. Played back to Amanda Brady. Now here's Cora Lapsley. Good ball in, looking for McCandless, but well intervened and intercepted again by Tara Melvin. She's enjoyed a great season, Melvin, answers so much of the Jets side. Under 16 into provincial crown for Connacht for the first time. Connacht Schools Championship as well. One of four trophies claimed by the Jets this season. They want a fifth. They're 5 minutes away from golden goal extra time. Or are they possibly seconds away from a winner? Alison Ryan.
This is where the goal came from, this type of situation the last time.
Trainer, is there a carbon copy coming then? How aware a foil of the danger? Maybe not aware enough! Elaine Carey, 13 years old, the heroine for the Jets. They didn't learn.
Yeah, all their chances have come from that exact play. And Carey, she's been really fun to watch. She's been active, she's been quick, she's been involved. She's a really good prospect for this team.
So how do Foyle save themselves now? Here goes Leanne Orr. Well stopped by Tara Melvin. Free hit out. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why Gene Muller is Ireland coach and why he's our expert. Two one to the Jets with 4.5 minutes to go. Minutes and 50 seconds played. Just about 3 minutes remaining. Brona McKinley. Can Foyle save themselves now? They've had a season to dream of themselves, their first Ulster crown since 1982. Now in a competition dominated by Ulster teams, trying to keep the provinces end up. Fraser has engineered a free hit. We have 2 minutes, 20 seconds to go. Too far. Thank you. Megan Fraser's goal put Foyle ahead, but since then they've conceded twice. Touched on by Leonor. They can save themselves now! Good strike by McCandless, and Malloy has pulled off another stunning save! Penalty corner it is, but how vital was that stop?
Yeah, they score this and this game goes to OT, so... But this is a moment of tension if ever you've seen one.
It doesn't matter for Foyle if it's plan A or plan Z. It has to work. We only have a minute left. And it's Fraser who spreads it. Jones flicked up and flicked in for 2-2! I think it's Abby Parker who got the final touch. But they have saved themselves.
Yeah, it came in off the defender. It seemed like the pass was just going wide. The ball comes in off the defender stick.
How cruel! Last touch from Tara Melvitt. And that was going wide. 40 seconds to go.
And make a name for yourself, Elaine.
Good save. Holly Lynch has done just that. The goal's gone down to Olivia Jones. It was going wide. 20 seconds to go. Abby Parkle, who was at the far post and who dived in with Tara Melvin to distract her, is now trying to distract the rest of the entire Jez team. Great final. 2-2. And it's not over yet. Golden goal, extra time. Will give us 15 minutes to decide this final. Cruelty against Tara Melvin. But that's what sport is. 60 minutes have played, but more to come. It's Clochdignoed 2, Foyle and Londonderry 2. Extra time to come. We are now literally down to next goal wins. 7.5 minutes per half. The goal in the next 15 minutes will win it, and the game will end there. Club championship, women's senior club championship last year was decided that way. Here's Olivia Jones. Megan Fraser has been so wonderful and entertaining to watch today, but will she be a winner today? Now's not the time for there to be a lapse defensively or otherwise. It is full throttle hockey. Taken by Camilla Little and Short. Fraser is still pounding every blade of artificial grass she can. By Jones, she's not the taker, Little is. Well stopped by Leanne Orr, who's been ever dangerous, especially on the break today, and there is a free hit in, and it's quickly taken, and Orr is on the run, she has support, she may go her own way, intervened, Little loses out, but it's a free hit, she lost her stick, challenged by Tara Melvin. Little, Short, Fraser, free hit out. All right, Mystic Muller, give me a winner.
not even in my most lucid moment could I pick a winner out of this one.
Amanda Brady, so much at stake here. No Connacht winner since 1988. Taylor's Hill of Galway, the only Connacht champions of all of Ireland. Ulster have made it. utter domination this decade. But it looked as if the Ulster hands were just being slipped off the trophy just before the end. It may yet happen in stoppage time, and it's the penalty corner for Jez. Chances here. Katie Kadar coming to take, and this is what she created. It's Katie Kadar to take. Flannery and Melvin are waiting. Kadar, Flannery. Good switch. Trainer. Good stop by Holly Lynch. Got in the way. Did the job that was required. In strenuous circumstances. 3 minutes of golden goal extra time played. And a foil ball. Extra use for the sponsor's hands. Long for Parkhill. Bates McLaughlin. And McLaughlin has to work hard. She's got three around her. And did enough. The backup has arrived. McCandless for Parkhill. Here goes Elaine Carey. She has pace. We know that now. She thought she had the winning goal as well. There's still an opportunity for her to produce one. The free hit will be tapped by Alison Ryan for Kadar, taking on McKinley. Another free hit for Lindsay Traynor. Dangerously in! And Isabel Mortimer has won it! The Westerwick!
Yeah, yet again, the pass coming from Traynor. They scored three goals. All of them have come from her. She has been my player of the match in terms of the ability to change the game around. But it's a fantastic result. It's been a fantastic game of hockey. It's been entertaining, it's been exciting, and there's been very, very high standards. So just a wonderful, wonderful tournament.
It won't be quiet on the Western Front now. The Jez have won it. Kalosh Dignord 3, Foyle and Londonderry 2. And all that's left now is Doreen Howe, the president of the Irish Hockey Association, has the Kate Russell Cup in her hand for Orla Calnett. The famine is over. Connacht and Galway, back of the top table. The West's awake and will stay awake, surely for the rest of the year. Glory, glory, Galway.